All right, so this week I started working on a grand piano. It's going to be at least two parts, but I got so excited working, I forgot to take any photos. So stay tuned and see how fun and easy this piano is going to be. Today is part one of I don't know how many parts this is going to take because this was a request. One of my Facebook fans, Patricia, asked how to make a grand piano. Her daughter wants a grand piano for her Barbie. I'm making a 1/12 scale. She'll need to make this in 1/6 scale for Barbie, but I'll kind of talk you through. Probably more in the blog than on here, but I'll talk about the differences. And she lives in Hungary, so she can't get a lot of the craft supplies that we have here. They're a little bit more challenged as far as getting things. So one of the they had tried, and one of their biggest problems was getting the shape right. Well, what I did to get the shape right is I found a top-down view of a grand piano on the internet. I just Googled that and I found one that was okay. And I'm actually going to use the same image later printed on better paper. We'll talk about that in a little bit. So I found that and I saved that to my hard drive. Then I found a couple of sites that gave me, and I've got another one in my on my hard drive that I didn't print out, that gave me the dimensions, how big a grand piano is. So I kind of went with an average. And I scaled my drawing to 1/12 scale. This size image is going to do two things. First off, it's my pattern. And then we're going to print the same image off in the highest quality possible. This is just a draft copy. This is just a low quality image from my computer. We're going to print a high quality image later on photo paper to actually use for the inside and for the keyboard. Because we don't want to have to make all those. So this is our pattern. I cut it out and I used it to cut out three piano bases. And this is a cereal box, just the box of generic Frosted Flakes. This is what we are going to use for our building material. I've been using more and more cereal box and that kind of cardboard to do things. I'm using it a lot in my 18-inch doll stuff, which there will be a YouTube channel of craft projects for them coming up soon. I'm not quite ready to do that yet, to launch that. So our first step, and I did two of them one direction and one the other, simply so I won't have the printed side out. It'll be easier to paint later. And we are going to use yes paste. Now, if you don't have access to yes paste, any thick glue. Oh, I'm gonna buy more paste soon. Oh, I think I got another one in the other room. Any thick glue will work. You need something thick. You could probably use a glue stick. I like Yes Paste because it's a low moisture glue. It's a bookbinding paste. It's a low moisture glue, so it doesn't warp our things that we glue with it. Now we're still going to weigh this down though. So I'm going to glue the first two. This is the odd one, this one that's cut the other direction. I'm going to glue another one face to face with it, and I'm going to line it up as perfectly as I can. Now I'm going to spread another batch of glue on this edge, on this side. This is going to be the bottom of our piano. We're going to build the edge around it when this dries. So, and hopefully I won't have to redo too many things here because I'm actually going to For this week, I'm going as far as I get with the project and making a video of it when I get however far I get. And then next week, I'll come back and do some more. And hopefully I won't have to undo anything between weeks. But now these pieces all came out of one cereal box, in case you're wondering. I just save boxes. I've been saving them for a couple of weeks now for different projects. All right, so that's all glued together. And this is already a lot firmer than it was. So I need a wet wipe. I am going to probably put some wax paper on top of this, or maybe not. I'm going to weight this down and let this glue set up probably overnight, because I want this good and dry before we go to our next step. I've also cut hopefully enough 1-inch pieces to go around from here to here twice, because I want to do two layers there. So I'm going to let this dry, and I will
okay, I
be
think we're ready to move on.
Now, off camera, I cut another two strips and glued them together of our cereal box. This is 7/8 of an inch long. I measured where I want the back of the keyboard part to be, and I cut this to fit across. This is going to kind of support our sides of our piano. So it's only 7/8 of an inch long. That way I'm hoping, yeah, it's going to be about the right height for our piano. So what we are going to do, I'm going to run a bead of glue on my line that's 5/8 of an inch from the front of the keyboard. And I got that 5/8 of an inch, by the way. Let me find my little diagram, my little picture here. That's where this is. This is going to sit right here so the keyboard can kind of come in around the front of it. And I want some scotch tape to help hold it. I really want this to stay. It's going to be hard to get it to cooperate, I'm afraid. And then I also took an emery board and made sure that this was smooth on both sides. That way it will sit flat. I'm going to put some drops of super glue here. And I'm going to set that down. Got the tape. I'm not going to need the tape. Thought I would, but I don't think I will. I think that's going to stay just fine now. So ignore the part where I took the tape off. We'll just let this, I'm going to let this dry all the way so that it will help support our piano sides when we get to that step. So after the glue dries, I will be back.
All right,
so this is now set. So our next step is going to be, I think I'm going to actually kind of roll my strips, two of my strips around my glue bottle, just so it's not completely straight anymore. That way it'll take some of that stiffness out. All right, now, I want to take these strips from this point all the way around to the same point on the other side. So, let's run some glue. And I do have some tape on my sitting here on my tile in case I need it. I may or may not. I forgot to set my glue bottle upside down. Now on this one, I'm going to leave this out, and then we are going to run another strip of cardstock, or the same cardboard type stuff, on the outside. So that one I will run with the plain side out. This is staying pretty well. I think I will, yeah, it's going to need to be taped.
I want to run the edge so the edge is even with the base here. To get away from me. I'm just going to put a dot of super glue right in the seam there. Yeah, that'll help. And I think I'm going to wait until this glue dries before I try to put on the second piece of cardboard. But I didn't put glue there. Another bead of this same fast grab tacky glue all the way around the seam. Hoping I'm not getting my head in the camera. I'm trying to see through the back side of the project here. Okay. Now that will need to dry, and after this has time to dry, I think I'm going to give this a good, at least a good couple of hours, if not overnight, for this glue to dry. I will come and move it around on my tray from time to time though, so it doesn't glue itself to the tile. But so far this is going really well, so I'm really happy. So I'll be back when this glue has time to dry. All right, so this glue is set up. It's not dry all the way, but I think I can go ahead and add this part. Now, this one I didn't twist around because this is going to go on a straight area here. So I'm going to mark how long it is, and I'm going to go ahead and cut it. I think it will be easier to deal with if I have just the piece I need. Now, once again, I know this is probably not very exciting because we're just doing the same thing. We are going to coat this edge in glue. Put that edge in glue. I'm going to put this on here. And I think it's okay if they don't come completely together. We are going to deal with that when we glue the next piece on. Well, it looks like I don't need as many pieces of tape as I got out. And this one, I don't think I need the super glue on it either. I'm going to run another bead of glue because I want that to be sealed. I want a good end there. And I'm okay with this not being perfectly straight because there will be another piece in front of it and this will be partially covered. So now this side is on. This I do want to dry all the way, and then we are going to add this piece over it. And we'll be adding this piece. I think I'll start at this end when I add this piece. And go around. So this needs to set up. I need this glue all the way dry. And I think I'll leave the tape on too, but I will get clothespins to clothespin that onto this. So we're going to let this glue dry, and then I will be back. All right, so this has dried overnight now. So now it's time to put the second layer of cardstock on, and this is already pretty firm. Excuse me. So I want to line this up so that my seam is not even with the other seam. So I'm going to start from this end and work around. And I did end up cutting another piece of that because I can't find mine. Now I'm using Yes Paste for this step because I don't want this to buckle. And I want to have something that will really adhere these two pieces together securely and nice and flat. And it doesn't matter if the tape is on there. I'm just leaving that Scotch tape right on there that I had earlier. And where did I lay? Oh, right next to me. So I'm going to line this up. And then I have some my box of clothespins next to me so that, because I want to make sure that this adheres right to these curves that we've already started. I don't want to tape this layer because I don't want tape left on this when I get done. Not going to cut that off until the glue is dry. When the glue is dry, I will come back and cut that. And I think I'm going to. So I really want to make sure those spots stay together. I'm going to clamp there too. And there! Now, whoops, in the place that used to be clamped. This is the time to go around and make sure that you are, that everything is stuck together really nicely. Because this is our final shape of our piano. So now this will need to dry. I'm gonna give this several hours, possibly overnight, I haven't decided. When it's completely dry, I'll come back, we'll trim this, and we'll go on to the next step. All right, so this should be dry enough to take these clamps off and go to our next step. And our next step is actually going to be cutting after we cut this front piece off. I'm gonna cut this off even with that. Now, we need a lid. And our lid needs to be just a little bit bigger. So what I'm going to do, got another cereal box here. I'm going to put this like this. I'll trace it the first time, and then I will turn off the camera and cut this out. I'm going to trace this around. And it doesn't need to go all the way, but I'm going to go this far, and then I'll take a straight edge. I'll trim this to size after I get it put together. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to trace that line. Hopefully you can see that. I'm going to trace that. I'm going to turn it upside down and trace another one and cut that out. So I'll have two pieces when I come back. All right, so I've cut out two of these. I just used the first one and traced around it to cut the second one. I've got one going each way. That way, once again, we can glue with the label part of our cereal box on the inside. Yeah. Some more Yes paste. I'll show you what I do to hold this down. Because this could still, even though I'm using Yes paste and it's a low moisture glue, it could warp. And also be careful because it's going to want to adhere itself to your work surface. I glued one of these to my tile a while back. All right. But since this is easy to clean up, get a wet wipe. Wipe my hands up first so I get that clean. Now, make sure you get all the air bubbles out. Kind of feel around it. And then, around. And it's okay if one's bigger. We can trim that back. Depending on how this fits, that may actually be advantageous when we are done. Make sure there's no paste on our tile. I've got another tile, just a small one. Put that upside down and find something heavy. There. Now that needs to dry. When that paste has had a chance to dry, I will come back and show you the next step. This got dry last night, and I actually did a couple of things since I recorded last, because I wanted to do this off camera so I could get it just right. The first thing I did when this got dry, I took it out and I trimmed around so that both edges were even. Then I used an emery board and I evened off the edges. Then I made two cuts. First, I cut this back, so it was about, I would say about a quarter inch shy of this front edge on our piano. We have our, my next little bits in here. We have our sides of our piano, and I'm gonna leave mine straight. I've seen online some of them are cut back. I might cut it back, probably not. I'm gonna leave it straight, I think. But I cut this whole piece so it was about a quarter inch shorter than that. Then I cut off 3/4 of an inch. And there's a reason that's... So first I want to mark now my quarter inch. I'm upside down. Because we are going to be gluing this. We are getting ready to start doing more assembly. This will all be painted really soon. For this, I'm just using tacky glue. I'm going to run some tacky glue on top of here. And this 3/4 inch part is that stationary part in front of the part that opens. Now, I haven't decided if I'll put another piece inside of there or not. Behind the keyboard. We'll figure that out soon. All right, so this is now set where I want it. Now, if you were going to glue the top of your piano shut, you could glue it on now, but I'm not going to. I'm going to attempt, and like I said earlier in the video, I'm making this up as I go. I think I've got an idea for how to make this so it can be open or closed, but we shall see. Now we need piano legs. We need legs for our piano to sit on. So what I did, I measured, well, first I looked online and it looked like the pianos I was looking at online were about 39 or 40 inches tall. So in miniature, that's going to translate to around 3 3/8 of an inch in height. And most of the pianos like this I saw had three legs. So I took some golf tees and I just cut off the very end. I made these each, this is an inch tall, so these are each 2 3/8 inches tall. And I remembered I saw on a video someplace a long time ago cutting round things with dog claw clippers, and it worked really well. It didn't distort the shape at all.
I kind of sand it down. We'll have to even these up when they get done. So I'm going to turn our piano over, and I want to put one here. So make sure I have this where you can see. One here, and I'm kind of looking off camera at my little pictures I pulled from online, and one about there, I think. You need a really good adhesive, and I've got this sample package of different goop glues. I decided to use the Amazing Goop Contact Adhesive and Sealer for this one, because this should glue really well. This should make it hold up a little bit to being moved around a bit. Let's put some on each corner, each spot. I like these little sample packages of adhesive. They're really handy to have on hand. And by the way, if you're using goop, I'm going to have to open my windows here now, because since I'm done recording, because this stuff smells really bad. I really don't like it, but it does hold really well for things like this. So I'm going to put that in there. Now, if you don't have golf tees, you could use dowels. Use almost anything. I like the shape of the golf tees. And if you're doing a Barbie size, I saw some taller golf tees at the sporting goods department of a store locally. So you can probably use those. But now this needs to set. When this is set, I'm going to talk to you about what else we've got here. The other thing we need is a toothpick. I'm going to use a toothpick as my brace for my top, because my top will be opening. So these things, this lid, this entire structure, and the toothpick. Off camera, I am going to spray with black spray paint. Hopefully I've got a high gloss black spray paint. Otherwise I'll paint it with black and then put a gloss finish over it. So next time you see this, these legs will be dry. I will double check that everything sits level. Legs will be dry and this entire structure will be painted a shiny black. Then we can move on to putting the insides in, the keyboard in, and putting the top on. So let's let this dry. Well, I decided that rather than painting it this week, I'm going to paint it next week because I'm kind of running out of time. So I thought we would do a quick recap here. And I got out one of my dolls, and I think this looks, the size on this is really good. I really like this. I have to decide if I'm going to make a bench to go with it. But this is standing. It's standing nice and level. If it wasn't, I would just take an emery board to the bottoms of the legs. But the glue is just about dried. So I will be back next week. And I think next week we'll probably get this completely finished. I don't think it'll take more than one additional week. But if I'm going to get this video up on time for Sunday morning, I need to get editing. So I hope you enjoyed our project so far. Be sure and come back next week and see how this looks when it's finished. I think it's going to be pretty incredible. Be sure to check the blog posts. I will try to remember to put the measurements for the sizing of everything on there, so you can see where that, what that sizing needs to be. I'm just really excited about this project. So I will talk to you later. Be sure and check us on Facebook and come back again.